Friends, till now I have explained about what is stream analytic, how does stream analytic works, stream analytic reference architecture. In this video, we can start with stream analytic data processing with an example. Before starting the session, I would like to quickly introduce about myself. My name is Satish Varda, working as a senior big data engineer in KPRO Solutions Private Limited. KPRO is a leading provider in data lake, cloud implementation, IoT, blockchain, machine learning, artificial intelligence, deep learning, and mobile application development. We need some prerequisites. Start with stream analytic data processing example. That is Azure subscription, knowledge about SQL queries, and sample data file with four columns: time, DSPL, DEMP, and HMDT. If you are not familiar with SQL queries, please subscribe our YouTube channel and go through the SQL related videos. To explain the stream analytic data processing, let's take a scenario. Contaso, which is a company in the industrial automation space, it has completely automated its manufacturing process. The machinery in the plant has the sensors that are capable of emitting streams of data in real time. In this scenario, a production floor manager wants to have a real insights from the sensors data to look for patterns and take action on them. We will use the stream analytics query language over the sensors data to find the interesting patterns from the incoming stream of data. Here, data is being generated from a Texas Instrument sensor tag devices. The payload of the data is in JSON format and look like this. As mentioned in part of prerequisite, you need Azure subscription to log into the Azure portal. I have logged into the Azure portal by using my credentials. In the Azure portal, click the plus symbol, which is nothing but a create resource. Then type here stream analytics job. In the drop down you will see stream analytics job, and then click the create button. After selecting the create stream analytics job, page will look like this. Enter the job name and verify the subscription. Then either create a new resource group or use an existing one. Here I am entering the unique job name, KPRO IoT device data processing and in the subscription I am selecting pay as you go. That is the details I have taken. In the resource group, either create a new one or use existing one. I am using the creating the new one. That is KPRO Solutions Private Limited. Then click OK. And select the location. In the location, I am selecting Central India. Then finally click the create button. You should see a deployment in progress status in the right of your browser. Soon it will change to deployment completed. Then select the pin to dashboard option. Now, newly created stream analytics job is placed in your dashboard. After your job is created, it's time to open and build a query. You can easily access your job by clicking the tail option from here. Once you click on the tail, it will go to the job topology panel. In the job topology panel, click the query option. The query editor allows you to enter a T-SQL query that performs the transformation over the incoming event data. Here we have a few examples like archiving your raw data, filter data based on a condition. For easy understanding purpose, I am considering a JSON file as an input instead of IoT devices stream data. In upcoming videos, I will going to explain about live streaming data configuration. Now, let's start with archive your raw data example. Create the query to archive your raw data from input to your designated output. For that, here I have selected IoT output and IoT input. Click the three dots next to your IoT input and select upload sample data file. I am importing JSON file, so I have selected JSON as an option. If you are importing CSV file, then you can select CSV. If you are importing AVRO, you can select AVRO. In this example, I have selected JSON file and click here. I have already created a file that is nothing but IoT devices data and JSON. Once the file is selected, then click the OK. After uploading the sample file, you will get a notification like upload completed for the IoT devices data.json file. Then close the notification button. Click the test icon to test the data what you have uploaded. As a result, a new window will open below your query. Here you can see by dragging the data. It has a four column time, DSPL. DSPL is nothing but a sensor name, TAMP, which is nothing but a temperature, HMDT is nothing but a humidity. This is about archiving a raw data. Let's try to filter the data based on a condition. I would like to show the results only for events that are come from sensor A. This is the query which is written here. In this query, I have selected the time. DSPL is nothing but a sensor name. TAMP as a temperature, HMDT as a humidity into an IoT output from IoT input. And in the where class is nothing but a filtering class. Here DSPL is equal to sensor A. So this query will give you the required results based on a filter condition where sensor name is equal to sensor A. Once you have written this query, then click the test option from the top here. This query will execute and give you the required results. The query is written 389 rows out of 1860 events. So the file has total 1816 events. Out of that, only 389 rows are written. So all these 389 rows belongs to sensor A. So we have achieved the filter the data based on a condition. Now let's take another example. For every type of sensor, we want to monitor average temperature per 30 seconds window and display results only if the average temperature is above 100 degrees. This query will give you the required results. In the query, I have used two functions. One is tumbling window, second one is average. Generally, tumbling window functions are used to segment the data stream into distinct type of segments and perform a function against them. The key differentiators of a tumbling window is that they repeat but do not overlap, and an event can belong to more than one tumbling window. Average function will give you the average of the temperature. You can get more information about SQL functions, which is provided in our website. Please subscribe our YouTube channel and go through the SQL functions video. Now let's come to the query which is written here. In the select class, I am selecting the system timestamp as an output time, DSPL as a sensor name, and the function average of temperature as an average temperature into IoT output from IoT input and the timestamp by class group by tumbling window of every 30 seconds and group by sensor name. Having function filters the average temperature greater than 100 degrees condition. Once you are able to write this query, then click the test query option and the query will execute and it will give the results in the below window. You should see 245 rows out of 1860 events where average temperature is greater than 100 degrees. This query groups the stream of events by DSPL name and tumbling window of 30 seconds. So this is about filtering the data based on the conditions. I have created a document whatever we have discussed till now. You can get this document from our website. So far we have discussed creating a stream analytics job, uploading a JSON file to the stream analytics input, writing the sample query to see the uploaded data, creating the query to filter based on a condition. Thanks for watching this video. In next session, I am going to explain about data connections, event processing order design choices, stream analytic outputs, real-time Twitter sentiment analysis, scale your Azure Stream Analytics job by increasing stream data processing throughput, optimize your job to use your streaming units efficiently, using reference data or lookup tables in Stream Analytics. Kindly provide your valuable feedback as a comment and let us know any topic you want us to make a video or any issues which you are facing in your project. As part of this video, I am going to ask a question. That is, you are planning to implement a Microsoft Azure Stream Analytics job to track the data from IoT devices. You will have the following two jobs. Job 1 will contain a query that has one non-partitioned step. Job 2 will contain a query that has two steps. One of the steps is partitioned and one of the step is not partitioned. Then what is the maximum number of streaming units that will be consumed in job 1 and job 2? I'll let you know the answer for this question in next video. Meanwhile, you can guess for the answer and put your answer as a comment. Thanks for watching this video. Let's keep learning. Kindly provide your valuable feedback as a comment and let us know any topic you want us to make a video or any issues which you are facing in your project. You may write us on feedback@kpro.co.in. Please subscribe our YouTube channel to learn more topics like blockchain, cloud, data science, data lake, DevOps, and more. Follow us on YouTube, Twitter, LinkedIn.